It is a pleasure to meet you. Okay? It's a pleasure to meet you. I am very happy. I am very joyful. I am blissful. There are four terminologies you use. Are they one and the same or they have some difference? So what is pleasure actually? When you say it is pleasure, what is pleasure?
It's more of sensual.
Pleasure is when your sense organs make a contact, that's called pleasure. When your sense organs are making contact, it is called pleasure. So, when you drink a cup of coffee, it's a pleasant taste. Okay? So, the pleasant is always associated with the unpleasant. Pleasant has a bipolar opposite called unpleasant. Right? So, pleasure always has a pain. The pleasure and pain are counterparts. Then what is happiness then? What you call as happiness is what? If pleasure is sense contacts, happiness is what? So, what is happiness? What is the difference between pleasure and happiness? Is there a difference between pleasure and happiness?
It is associated with the mind.
So, the happiness is mental contact. The pleasure is physical contact. The pleasure is contact of the sense organs, physical. Happiness is mental contact. So, you can have a pleasant experience only when you drink a cup of coffee. Okay, but mental contact can be anytime. Oh, I'm so happy about my friend. The friend is somewhere. Your mind is connected with the friend now. Okay, I'm so unhappy. I lost something sometime back. So now the mental contact is called happiness and unhappiness. Okay, the physical contact is called pleasure and pain. Mental contact is called happiness and unhappiness. Then the nature of individual, jiva, is called joy and sorrow. Hey, he's a jolly fellow here. You see, anytime he is be joyful, he is in depression here. Okay? So what has happened to this joyful fellow and depression fellow? Most of the time they are joyful or most of the time in depression. So for the depression fellow, if whatever comes, okay, he got money, oh, so what? Okay, depression, yeah, the world is misery, always he says. Joyful fellow, hey, it's like life is joyful, he'll say. Right, joy and misery have gone deeper into you. It has become a part of you. Okay, they're also opposite, joy and misery. So what is the joy and misery? It has become your nature. It's your become behavioral pattern, right? Or rather, it's your basis. Then what is bliss? Spirituality is about bliss. Someone should be able to tell. What is bliss?
That is within, when you're in touch with your being. Huh? When you're aware, to be aware of your being and operate from that state, then you are in a
blissful state. So, bliss has no counterpart. Pleasure has pain. Happiness has unhappiness. Joy has sorrow. The bliss. Okay. So the bliss is beyond pleasure and pain, happiness and unhappiness, joy and sorrow. So the entire spirituality is for being blissful. So being blissful is actually not the right word. Being is blissful. Okay. So becoming is misery. Understand? Being is bliss. Becoming is misery. What is this fellow becoming and being? Who is becoming what? Keep it open. Bliss is actually beyond. Bliss is not dependent on anything. Bliss is not dependent on anything, independent of anything. Okay. So now how you can be independent of anything? Is it possible? Not possible. How is it possible? How is it possible, Robin? Is it possible to be independent of anything? No, I'm not thinking of wife, okay? Or husband. Other than that. Is it possible your happiness and bliss being independent of anything? How? How? How you can be independent of anything?
When
it includes everything or when you exclude everything?
Exclude.
When you exclude everything or include everything, you can independent. Okay. So independent of anything, by including everything or excluding everything. Okay, so including everything means pain and pleasure, both are included. So tomorrow I'll say pain and pleasure, both are okay. Then you become independent of that. Otherwise you'll exclude pain, the pain, I don't want pain, I want a pleasure. Right? Or exclude everything. I don't have anything, pain or pleasure. So now how can you include everything in life? Tell me. Do you accept pain and pleasure? Accept. How? No. So how can you accept pain and pleasure both equally? What is this possible? How?
This is for body.
and this is for mentally. We can leave that one. Pleasure
and pain. Who is we?
Huh?
Who is we?
To capital I.
I. So, when you understand very clearly, the real I is not dependent on anything. Okay, real I is not dependent on anything. The false I is dependent on happiness and unhappiness. Okay, false I, not real I. Understand, Uma? Is Uma real I or false I? What all is included in false I? Your body is included in false I, mind is included in false I, your name is included in false I, profession is included in false I. It is false in, not in the sense it is not there, it is a transactional or temporary identity. Your real identity, I, is never disturbed by anything. Has it changed in your life? Your I has changed?
No.
So 20 years back, how old are you now?
18.
So which city you are born?
2000.
Where were you born?
Hyderabad.
Okay, now where are you?
Bangalore.
So you are in Bangalore and you are born in Hyderabad. So what has not changed in these, in between these two?
I.
Hyderabad has changed? Place has changed?
Yeah.
Your body has changed?
Yeah.
Your mind has changed?
Yeah.
Your thoughts have changed? What has not changed?
I have not
changed. Have you changed?
No.
There is an unchanging part in our life and there is a changing part in life. Okay? The unchanging part and changing part, there are two parts in our experience of life. Are you clear? The unchanging part never changes. So what are you? Are you changing part or unchanging part?
Unchanging part.
And who is searching for happiness? Dev, okay? If it is not you, why are you bothered about it? Huh? What is it? So we have two parts in our life. Okay? The changing part and unchanging part. Changing part will change every day, morning, evening, night, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, it will keep changing. Okay? Right? Unchanging part will never change. Now between these two, what are you?
Unchanging.
Are you? Then happiness and unhappiness comes to whom?
Unchanging.
Changing part is happy for some time, unhappy for some time. Then why are you bothered about that fellow? If you are unchanging part. Huh? For whom is the spiritual search?
Unchanging part.
For unchanging part, why are you doing search? It has not, nothing has happened to you. For the changing part, and it will never get it because it's not changing. The moment you get it, it will say, oh, something else is required. That's why the spiritual search is also false. One false I is not a real I. The real spiritual search is understand who am I. Okay, there's not a path. You understand? The changing I will say has a one mantra. Mantra of changing I, I'll tell you. I'll repeat it to me, okay? Honge kamyab. Hum honge kamyab. Ek din. Yeah, please repeat, no? Honge kamyab. Hum honge kamyab. Ek din. So, this guy who is changing pai, also, this guy is the one who is taking you to all the spiritual searches. Honge kamyab ek din. I'll get enlightened one day. Realize one day, I will be blissful one day. That is honge kamyab ek din, it will never come. That's where the spiritual journey is not real. The understanding who is searching for the spiritual journey is real. Robin, samajh mein aa gaya? This changing part will never be satisfied. Even anything you get, it will not be satisfied because you want something more. Okay? Assuming that one day the changing guy becomes enlightened, then you say, what is beyond enlightenment? I want something more. You will never stop that. Understand? So, unchanging I is what you have to stay, understand all the time. Then pleasure and pain is coming to the changing I. Right? If something is coming to not you, changing I is not you, then why are you struggling in life? So then you will be equanimous. The pain is there. Yeah, it is there.
We should become Buddha then.
Now what are you?
You are a Buddha.
Now what are you?
I don't know.
Now what are you?
I don't know.
So what is required to make you Buddha? We will make you. I mean, in this class, after this class, I will make you Buddha. What is required to make you Buddha?
You have to leave each and everything.
How can you leave anything? Can you leave you have to leave the body.
Yeah.
Okay, leaving wife is not important. Right? Husband is not
mind, body, everything.
Buddha was walking all the street, all the days. He was walking for 40 years. He was talking. How did he leave the body? I mean, he has to die, is it?
No. In our mind, we should say that we are not body.
You don't have to say that. You are not the body at all. You have to say that I am woman every day.
No.
What is real, you don't have to repeat. You have to understand very clearly, right? So you can become Buddha only by jnana. Buddha is not a person at all. This is a foolishness. Buddha is not a person. One who has buddhi is called Buddha. One who doesn't have buddhi is called pedda.
Buddha.
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 Okay.
Buddha.
So you will become Buddha when. Nanu.
Nanu.
Nanembudu.
Nanembudu.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Ideha.
Ideha.
Manabuddhi.
Manabuddhi.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Sachidanandatma.
Sachidanandatma.
Shivananu nane.
Shivananu nane.
Shivoham.
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 I am not the body.
I am not the body.
I am not the mind.
I am not the mind.
I am not the intellect.
I am not the intellect.
I am pure consciousness.
I am pure consciousness.
Shivaswarupi.
Shivaswarupi.
If you understand this, you are a Buddha. If you don't understand this, you are a Pedda. Understand the difference. Buddha became Buddha by Buddhi. Or nothing else. Living wife was a convenience actually. Headache is gone. Nothing to do with the Buddha. Buddha is, when Buddhi becomes pure, then you are Buddha. We start thinking, oh Buddha, okay. I have to become Buddha. First thing I have to do is my wife or husband. Then I will become Buddha. There is nothing to do with that.
Not by Nisangatva.
Huh?
Not by Nisangatva.
Nisangatva of what? Manasu Buddhi Deha, not Sangha. Adu Sangha Allah. This is your problem. Nisanga means you think that wife is a Sangha, husband is a Sangha. No. Manasu and Buddhi and Deha. You Himalaya ko sannyas the way. Deha Manasu Buddhi Nanam Pramehidra Mugitu. Finished. One case. So, by the clarity you understand, I am not the body. With the clarity. That's why Atmadnana is possible only for human beings, that intellect is developed. For animals, it's not possible. And Buddha became Buddha where Buddhi flowered. Intellect flowered. Okay. No. One day I'll leave everything. What will you go? Where will you go? Can you leave the body? I mean, even after Buddha became Buddha, body was carrying. So only understand your relationship to the body. So the body, mind, and intellect are changing parts. I am the unchanging part. The moment you become unchanging part, you are in nirvana.
You don't become the unchanging part because you are.
Understand. Right? So that is called nirvana. So otherwise what we are actually constantly searching for spiritual. It is not there. Understand? So bliss means beyond pleasure and pain, beyond happiness and unhappiness, beyond joy and sorrow, is called bliss. So understanding that this happiness and unhappiness, pleasure and pain, joy and sorrow doesn't belong to me, that is called bliss. Otherwise you look for a super kick. I'll get a blast. Understanding A, B, C about doesn't belong to me. It's called bliss. Then what belongs to you? I can't say. But at least these are not for me. These are there. They come and go. But not for me. I am the witness of this. This is called bliss. You understand? Otherwise, you are constantly searching for enlightenment, which is completely false. You understand? There is no such thing as enlightenment. Enlightenment is light. For whom is the light? The intellect which is corrupted, which is in darkness. And that can come only with clarity. See, everything in life has a happiness and pleasure and pain, everything is mixed. For you, real I, is there a problem anytime?
No.
That understanding, that's why only Jnana can give Mukti. Nothing else can give. Whatever you do, 10,000 hours of meditation, or 50,000 hours of satsanga, okay, or 100,000 hours of karma yoga, clear Jnana. Who is I, who is not I? And you constantly leave that real eye. False eye, you say, okay, it's a false eye. It's coming and going. False eye doesn't, it's changing. Understand? Otherwise, your spiritual search will never end. Because whom you are trying to satisfy? The small eye, the false eye. It never gets satisfied. You understand?
So, the feeling of I amness, that is not the real eye.
No. That's also a manifestation, reflection, because I amness is not there in deep sleep, no. It is coming and going.
Last time you mentioned two words, Chidabhasa and Chittakasa.
Chidabhasa is that.
I amness.
It appears and disappears. When you wake up in the morning,
it appears.
When you go to deep sleep, awareness is there.
Chittakasa, what is that?
Chittakasa is mind space, mental space.
That is also gone in deep sleep.
Now I am seeing the entire world, it's in mind space, mental space. The physical space is seen in mental space. That also disappears. But what doesn't disappear is awareness.
Attention is
when the body, mind and intellect is the instrument. Right? For what? Experience. The steering that instrument called body, mind, intellect for getting a specific experience called attention. Okay?
So like right now focus on the belly or I can focus on the breath. That is, I am using the steering wheel or attention faculty.
Attention is your steering wheel of the vehicle called body, mind, intellect. So wherever you go, that experience comes to you. And who knows that there is experience? The awareness. Experience is happening because of body, mind, intellect. Attention is the driving wheel, steering wheel. And who knows that there is experience? Awareness, knowingness. Awareness never changes. Experience changes depending on where you go.
But who is steering this wheel?
We'll find out. We'll find out, right? So now we'll find out who is the steering the guy, right? If you find out the fellow, the problem is over. The class is over.
Even I have the same doubt.
Who is steering? The answer is nobody is steering. I'll tell you why.
Self-driving car.
It's self-driving car. Who is not? Nobody is driving. I'll try. But first, you understand the plane, pleasure, and this. You understood? Mm-hmm. So bliss means, what is the meaning of bliss really? So. This I call it as A, B, C. A, B, and C. So bliss is understanding, realizing, understanding that A, B, C are not for real I. A, B, C are for false I. If this understanding is there, you are blissful. And that person who has understanding is called Buddha. And that's he, that person is called Shiva. Now Shiva also you start making a person. No. Shiva is a state of consciousness, auspicious all the time. Anything happens in life, I am auspicious. My, for me, no problem. It's called Shiva. See, whole problem, what you are trying to do is we are making all this inner reality into a person. Buddha is Buddhi, intellect, is inner reality. It's not a person. Then you'll say, oh, I have to become Buddha, then I have to... First of all, I have to have a palace, no. First condition for becoming Buddha is I have to have a palace. Okay? Without having a palace, you can't become Buddha. Second condition is you have to have a wife, right? And a child. And you have to wait right at the time when the child is born and you have to leave your house, leave your palace. Otherwise, you'll never become Buddha. See, what all condition you are putting? Huh? Then you have to sit 6 years in the forest, right? Then tiger should come. Now the forests are not there, first of all. The tiger and, if the tiger comes, you will run away first. You have to sit. After that, Buddha. So becoming Buddha is impossible. We'll come to a conclusion. But without understanding, Buddha means Buddhi. Intellect. Buddhi which has become purified is Buddha. Now for that purified intellect, how many places you have to go? You have to all the way, you have to come to 21st floor. No. There's no requirement that you have to have a palace. Okay? Right? So for becoming Shiva, at least you have to be in Kailasa. You'll go to Kailasa after a day, but that's a different thing. So there's no such requirement. Please understand, this all clarity. It's called Atmadarshana. Understand? If you keep on looking for enlightenment as an experience, you'll never get it. Got it? Enlightenment means understanding that physical happiness, mental happiness, and joy and sorrow doesn't belong to me. This is called enlightenment.
Joy and sorrow also mental only.
Mental only. It has gone deep rooted into subconscious. Okay? It has actually, there's no now contact not required. Now you have become a habit. Earlier happiness was because happiness, if you drink a bottle of whiskey, you become happy. So after time, sometime you don't get a bottle of whiskey, you become unhappy. You become unhappy for longer, then you become sorrowful. You got depression now. You have become very habit. If you get a whiskey or you don't get a whiskey, whatever you get, you are unhappy. It has become deep-rooted, habit. Are you clear? It's a habit. This has become deep-rooted habit. So any questions are there now, so far? Are you clear? Are you making progress in spiritual path?
Sure.
Spirituality has no path actually. The path is an illusion created again. Now we'll go to the experience and experiencer. We want a... Okay, so... I'll put...